Hi everyone. So today we are going to discuss the overview of smart materials. Now, let me discuss overview to smart materials. See, if so many materials are available, so why we are concentrating on smart materials? See the classification first before going to discuss the smart materials. See, the various materials which are available in our earth is like this. See, if you take the materials, if you can take the wood for usage, a lot of applications are available. Metals are having applications, polymers, ceramics, and composites. See, if these many materials are available, then what are the soft materials and how it is useful for the various products? So that part that we are going to discuss, and we are going to discuss the application of the soft materials also. Now, first of all, let me clarify what do you mean by smart materials here. See, smart materials are the materials that can significantly alter one or more of their inherent property. So that means it can change. This particular point is important here. That can alter, significantly alter one or more of their inherent property owing to the application. So depends on the application, depends on the end usage of the material, depends on the end usage of the product. This material can change its property. So that means of an external stimuli in a controlled fashion. So that's why it is represented as a smart materials. That means depends on the situation, depends on the product usage. Sometimes it will change the situation, it will change the property instantaneously. We can say that instantaneously. So because it is changing its properties instantaneously, depends on the situation, depends on the requirement, we can say that it is a smart materials. See, the several external stimuli to which the smart materials are sensitive are, so let me show you. One is stress. So that means if the stress varies, it will react the material. So that means whatever the material that you have taken, that you are saying as a smart material, it will react with respect to the stress. Will react with respect to the temperature. That means if any temperature changes are observed, it will react. If any moisture changes are observed, it will react. If any pH changes are observed, it will react. If any electric fields are having some change, it will react. So that means all these things which are external stimuli to which the smart materials are sensitive. That means which depends on the stress, depends on the temperature, depends on the moisture, it will react. And it depends on the magnetic field. If the magnetic field is available, the particular this one will, that is a smart material, will react here. Now, let me show you some of the important point. What is exactly the smart material is represented as, that is at the outside world. So in general, it is a significant, S stands for significant, measurable. We can say that it is a measurable. That means what are the changes that are observed that can be measured, that can be quantified in this materials? That means significant, measurable. A stands for appropriate and R stands for result oriented. That means whatever the requirement that you want, depends on your requirement, the smart material will change its properties. And it is very much useful to adapt to different situations. Whatever the situations are happened, it will react accordingly. So that means it is a self-motivated system. So that's why it is very much useful for the various situations and for various products. Here, totally we can call the smart materials as significant, measurable, appropriate, result-oriented, and time-oriented. So time is also very, very important when you consider the smart materials. You can see here the various smart materials which are available at outside world, that is by pledging the various industries. And for those smart materials, so what are the various inputs and what are the various outputs here? If you take the piezoelectric material means it reacts whenever the stress is observed. That means if you give the stress on this material, automatically it will react. So what is the input here? Here the input is for this piezoelectric material, the input is deformation. So that means it is undergone the load. So output is a potential difference. So depends on the potential difference, we can identify how much change is observed, how much deformation is observed in the material. So electrostatic tube, this is second, that is another smart material in which the input is potential difference. So the input is itself is a potential difference, then the output is deformation. That means we can read in terms of the deformation, that is in electrostatic materials. If it is a magnetostatic material, the input is magnetic field. So we have to give the magnetic field, or we have to generate the magnetic field. Depends on that, you can identify the deformation. The next one is a thermoelectric. So for thermoelectric materials, here the important point, that is input is a temperature, the output is here the potential difference. So this is the output. That means we cannot identify the temperature directly, but with the help of potential difference, we can identify how much temperature has changed. The shape memory alloys. What do you mean by shape memory alloys here? So that means even though due to the temperature, some deformation will be observed in the material, that is, it has taken as an input, but after some time, after further deformations, again it will regain its shape. So thus it is remembered its shape. So that is called as a shape memory alloys. The output we can see as a deformation. If the deformation is happened due to the temperature, then it can be considered as a shape memory alloys. That is like austenite. That means if you heat the material, that is in iron and copper diagram, until it reaches to austenite, so that type of deformations can be considered under shape memory alloys. If it is a photochromic, radiation is the input, color change is the output. If it is a thermochromics, temperature is the input, color change is the output. So these are the various piezoelectric, all these things are various smart materials, and these are the inputs. So depends on these inputs, we will get outputs. See, if you see input and output clearly, we can say that we cannot get the value directly. You have to manipulate, you have to convert the input into output. Depends on the value that we got, we have to convert, depends on the requirement. So this is the various classification. So let me show you just in some of the smart materials. It is a piezoelectric material, that is whenever stress is applied, it's a direct, this is indirect, yeah, there is no closed loop. So a lot of materials which are useful for the piezoelectric material, that is used as a piezoelectric material, are quartz material, rocher salt, topaz, bismuth, ferrite. All these are piezoelectric materials only. That means whenever the stress is applied on the material, it will deform, it will react. So that is called as a piezoelectric material. If it is an electrostatic material, so see the sentence here. If a dark material is subjected to an electric field, then it experiences with strain, this particular point, which is proportional to the strength of the electric field. So that means we cannot get the strength of the electric field directly. See this here. In initial stage, there is no current, but afterwards, a tension is applied or compression is applied. In the second image, tension is applied. In the third image, compression is applied. When you apply the tension or the compression, then automatically what happens is the strength of the electric field will change. So it cannot measure the strain directly, but it can change the strength of the electric field here. So if the changes are observed, automatically you can convert the strength of the electric field into strain. Okay, that is about electrostatic materials. A good example is lead, lanthanum, zirconate, that is a titanite. This is the best example for electrostatic material. And lead, magnesium, niobate, these are the another examples for electrostatic materials. See, if it is a magnetostatic material, see, this particular application is to a ferromagnetic material causes to change its shape. That means if it is a ferromagnetic material to cause change its shape here. That means this, whatever the shape change is observed, this shape change is proportional to the strength of the field applied. That means when you apply the tensile force or when you apply the compressive force, if the shape change is observed, the change in shape is proportional to the strength of the field applied. So this is the magnetostrictive material. A lot of examples are available. One example is cobalt and Teflon D. These are the two examples for magnetostrictive material. If it is a thermoelectric materials, as I already said that when subjected to any temperature difference, it produces proportional voltage output, and the reverse effect is also true. Actually, in the case of thermoelectric material, the thermoelectric effect generally, so generally comprise of effects here, that is the seedback effect. It is following these effects: seedback effect, Peltier effect, and the Thomson effect. So these are the three effects which follows thermoelectric materials. So let me explain this. This is cooling versus heating. This is a heat pump. This is the electricity generator. See, the connections are same. The only thing is inputs and outputs will change here. And PN junctions, in between cooling and heating, the entire system is having. So this electric current through a thermoelectric material, heating at one and cooling at the other here. So this is a lower green, this is thermoelectric material. You can say that this is a thermoelectric module. So depends on the say situation, it will change the properties. Here in the electricity generator also the same function, PN junctions. So these are made with smart materials. That is either here. A voltage is set up across the thermoelectric materials. When there is a temperature difference between the two ends, it will act. Okay, shape memory alloys. See, as I said in the earlier slides, so shape memory alloys means it is a metal alloys which can undergo solid to solid phase transformation and can recover completely when heated to a specific temperature. So that means recovery is important, and it recovered and it will remember its original shape. So this will happen for shape memory analysis. So these materials has two phases here. One is austenite, that is high temperature phase, and another one is material, that is martensite, low temperature phase. So these two are available. These two phases are available. Here you can see the image here. This is austenite. This is a martensite for heating. If you cool the austenite, you will get martensite like this. If it is deformed, again martensite will become like this. If you heat the material, again it will become austenite like this. If you cool it, it will become martensite like this. So this is the cyclic process, and we can say that all these happens, and it has to remember the shape. Okay, this alloy has to remember the shape. So these are the various smart materials. So in next coming sessions, we will discuss some more technological parts. So thank you. Thank you, one and all.